Hey folks, I'm tired. I was just playing some more Devil Daggers because Devil Daggers, God, that game. Oh, that game. I stayed up a little bit too late playing it last night, not intending to. I streamed some, played like garbage, was experimenting with farming to get the final upgrade a little bit earlier, and man, I didn't do well, turned everything off, said, okay, it's too late, I'm playing badly, I gotta go to bed. And then what did I do? 10 minutes later, I had an idea, and I booted the game back up and played for like another hour. That game is horrible. It's great, but it's horrible. Anyway, we're not playing Devil Daggers today. We are gonna play some more Grim Dawn, because this is really what I'm supposed to actually be working on. And have not been. Okay. Oops, there we go. But I did hit rank 365 on the leaderboard for Devil Daggers, so I'm pretty proud of that. That game is something else, I tell you. I think I wanted to... Yeah, I do want to use this, but I... Wait. Hold on here. Oh, yeah, okay. I guess I could have been using this? Why wasn't I? I guess I forgot that I had it and I leveled up and didn't use it. I don't know. It's not 100% amazing. Since there's some damage types we're not using, but I think it's still better. We'll see how it compares to the gun that we've been using. Now, where the heck did we leave off here? Use the strange key to enter the depraved sanctuary. I can probably do that now. I'm gonna do that. Me and my girlfriend attempted to do that last night when we played a little bit. We haven't been playing a lot. I've had a really busy time these last couple weeks. Oh right, this character, not the other character. Alright, this seems pretty effective. Yeah, the game has been more difficult. What am I doing again? Oh yes, I have these. The game has been more difficult playing with two people. I'm not sure how the game handles leveling of enemies and such. We died initially where I'm about to go. That was the first time that I had actually died. First time either of us had died in the game. And it didn't seem hyper leveled to us. I mean, it was a little tough, but it wasn't like super bad. But then when we went back, it seemed like it was worse. So I'm not sure what the deal was with that. If it actually leveled up at some point. I thought everything in this game was static. I could be wrong. I don't know. And there may be some sort of, you know, algorithm that determines the level. Although, no, this looks about the same. I want to say these guys were 17 and 18 when we came here. So yeah, it may well just be static. Yeah, this looks about the same. And there's the strange key, but we already got one, so we can't pick it up, I guess. Yeah. That's fine. But yeah, there's sort of a boss dude here who's a little on the rough side. Or at least he was when we fought him. Excuse me. He summons a lot of guys to help him out. Thank you. the same guy? Actually, I don't think it is. No, it's not. That's interesting. This is a different boss. What is that over my head? I do not know. Huh. Well, yeah, that's interesting. The guy we fought was a level 18... I don't know, some guy with a big hat. Looked like a... You know, just a big occultist, more or less. So that's interesting. Although, actually, now that I think about it, I've already been through this area, haven't I? Yeah. I've already been through this area, so... all that to say, I probably killed him already the first time, and maybe this is like a stand-in? Something that you get after the fact? I don't know. There's a lot of these kinds of systems that I don't know how this game handles things. That is nice armor that I cannot wear. I have leveled. I'm not sure what direction I want to go here. I'll throw another point in physique. Nope. No, definitely not. Okay. Look at our skills. I like these grenade things. Those are pretty cool. Oh, that's right. I had a point in this from that other item that I'm not currently using. And I think also that's where my poison bomb came from. And I can't use that now, if I'm not mistaken. Well, oh, and yeah, idiot me, I forgot to actually turn the witchfire on. So that's not helpful. I'll throw a point in that. I will throw two more points in the grenade. And, oh, okay. What is that on? Ah, it's on my offhand. And this had the slam, which I'm not using. Okay. Alright, good deal. Let's check out the rest of... No, there's nothing else here. Okay. Alright, let's dive into the... belly of the beast here. Use that strange key, and here we are. Uh-oh. Forgive me, that was a sneeze. I have been having something, I don't know what, allergies? My nose has been going a tad crazy. And I'm slightly afraid that I may have a sneezing fit coming on. Oh boy. Oh, hello. Look at all you guys. Can I throw anything in there? No, I can't. That would be too easy. Whoa, hello. Boy. Something hit me pretty good there. I do occasionally have trouble identifying where the sources of damage are coming from. It's one thing that I've noticed a bit. Sometimes I take a whole bunch of damage and I'm not really sure exactly what it is that caused it. In that case, I was probably just getting hit by a bunch of guys, you know, in the face. Since they were standing nearby me, but... You know, I like this weapon and all, but it doesn't really make sense. I'm all grenades at this point. So it's like, what am I doing, you know? I should just be focusing on ranged. My other character is going straight two-handed, as he's a shaman. And a lot of their skills take advantage of two-handed weapons. So this guy is kind of the polar opposite. So if I need to, I can swap to this thing and do some stuff. But I think it's better to be using the gun, and I think I need to continue to focus on ranged, because I like these grenades. I do like the grenades a lot. Come on, guys, drop me something good here. Still. But yeah, I have been enjoying multiplayer. Heather and I have enjoyed that quite a bit. It's very reminiscent of... Oh, hello. Of Diablo 2. Oh, wow. These guys are no joke. No, these guys are no joke. That is... I was going to say that might have been the dude that we fought before. No, these are different. These are definitely different. But they have the same summoning of the Void Fiends, which is a major issue. Man, there's a lot of these guys. Shielded.
I can't do that yet.
Yeah, I know. But I'm spamming it anyway, man. Uh-oh. And another thing that annoys me is the move key doesn't work especially well. That was one thing I appreciated very much in Diablo 3, is your dedicated move button. You could just kind of use that to avoid clicking on dudes. Like, I want to go over here, don't target anybody, you know, don't whatever. And in this game, it seems to get hung up sometimes and fails to... I guess they must have run back to their spawn point. Yeah, sometimes it's just like I will try to be clicking, you know, or hitting that move key to go somewhere. And instead it's like, now I'm targeting an enemy, I'm not going to do that properly. And it's very frustrating. I know I shouldn't really be focusing on these guys, but... Man, I think this fight is too tough for me right now. Oh! Death. Alright, well, we died. That fight is just a little bit too tough. Alright, so yes, we lose experience, but we can recover some of the experience lost by collecting our grave marker. So that's where we're gonna go. Oops, that was the wrong place. I don't want to go to the Foggy Bank. I want to go to the outskirts. Okay. But yeah, these guys may be a little too tough. They are quite a number of levels higher than we are. Oh, leave me alone, bugs. Come on. Don't need your shit right now. But I will say that the game does seem harder in multiplayer. It does. They, you know, ratchet up everything to account for the fact that there's two people. And we've, you know, we have good success just going about our business, doing our thing. We're using voice chat and we communicate and everything, and it works pretty well. However, let's see, these guys are probably back at their spawn point, I would imagine. What the heck was I just saying? But yeah, when we sort of don't communicate well and aren't playing, you know, as a team or whatever, it can get a little dicey. It can get a little dicey. Well, these guys are still hurt, but yeah, I've done almost no damage to them at all. I'm going to come back here. In a couple levels. And you know what? I should just port out. And let's head to the village. We're still looking at the Warden's Cellar. Where we're trying to get here. Medieval shotgun and zombies. Why not? Medieval Victorian? I don't know. They said Victorian in the early promos for this on Kickstarter. That was kind of the selling point. It was like, oh, it's going to have this cool kind of Victorian setting, and I'm not entirely sure that's been borne out. Like, this has a tendency to feel almost kind of like Western to me. Like this village, you know, just the way the shops are and stuff. Like, not Western exactly, but kind of. I guess when I think Victorian, I think more Victorian England, you know, as far as like a more developed society. And the countryside not feeling, well, I don't know, I guess you could consider this vaguely English, but yeah, I don't know, I guess the trappings of the Victorian era don't feel as prominent here. I mean, you can see stuff like this, you know, where it's like, yeah, that could be interpreted as Victorian. Some of the furniture and stuff like that. Some of which was kind of synonymous as well, or I should say simultaneous to a lot of, you know, Western development in the United States. Some of those visual things would be shared between the two. I think I've been down here. It's been a while since I played. Yes, we have been down here. We don't need to do that again. Anyway, all that to say that I'm curious where that will end up going, as right now, it just doesn't feel especially Victorian. And I remember seeing some of the earlier kind of preview-y stuff on the Kickstarter felt a little more in that direction. What was that? Oh, we can actually go over here? Ew. Where does this go? Abandoned waterfront. Okay. We're not going to do that just yet. But I don't know if I knew you could go over there. Maybe I did. It was slightly explored on the map, so maybe I ran over there before, but whatever. I'm trying to figure out what the heck I'm even doing here. Oh no, we're looking for the estates. The Brewich Estates, which are up there, and we've already gone there. Yeah, don't go so long without playing your games, guys, because then you just end up confusing yourself. Alright, maybe we will go to the abandoned waterfront and work our way around. That seems fine. Looks like they connect, so. Hello, Slith. With your conveniently snaky name. Oh crap. Okay, this looks like just another dump. Alright, let's check out the cave. That was real dumb. Okay, yeah, this is... Whoa. Some bad hitching again. Wonder if that's coming across on video. How much of it actually might be related to the fact that I'm recording video, as I really have not played this game to any degree without recording video. Or streaming, I should say. Yeah, this looks more or less just like a duplicate of another dungeon. Man, I forgot to turn on the Witchfire. I've invested 6 points in it, and I forgot to turn it on. That's probably not wise. Probably not. Okay, we got a blueprint, and... Can you guys not do that right now? Thank you. Let's, get our health back. Grab our vital essence. And yeah, okay, this is another one. It's just kind of a dupe of that other dungeon, more or less. Did we get anything good here? Energy regen, don't care. That is not that great of an amulet. Lightning damage, energy regen, and pet. No, that doesn't help us at all. Not at all. So. Oh, shoot. Kind of forgot I had a pet. I saw the pet damage and I was like, wait a second. And no wonder I'm doing so badly against those other guys. Maybe we can go back there and take them out. Maybe it wouldn't have been nearly so bad as I thought. Now I'm a little bit curious. Boy, that was pathetic. For some reason, I was thinking I had no pets on this guy, because Heather's playing an occultist in our game. So, hello, this is a decent set of gloves. Physical... Oh, shit! Wow. I did not realize that was poison. Guys, I'm not doing well. An epic two-handed... I believe this is a sword. Yeah, I found that on my other character, actually. And it was a really nice sword. Okay. These gloves. Physical damage. Ether damage. Oopsie. And what else? Pierce resistance? Reduced stun duration? I don't know. Those don't really seem that great. I'd sort of rather have the defensive ability, so I guess I'm just going to keep that. Fire damage, that's pretty good. And energy regen. As opposed to just an increase in cunning. What does cunning do again? Physical, pierce, and damage, duration damage. I guess that is pretty good. So like, how do I know? Well, let's take a look. Physical 91, alright, so 91, 86, 94, Okay. So yeah, we lose a substantial amount of damage with the drop in cunning. And probably that 8% fire damage isn't going to make up for that. I guess. Where's the exit? Okay. Oh, we got a nice item at least. Crystal time. Love my bombs. I do. I love them. Man, that dog's killing him before I can even shoot him. My dog is cool. Okay, we got some fabric. Oh, that's right. I was collecting this for the seamstress. I don't actually remember who the seamstress is, but that's what my quest log tells me, so I'll believe it. Okay, and there's a chest there. Alright, cool. It always weirds me out in this game why torches are always lit at night. You're always in like these abandoned areas, you know? Everything's like jacked up. And someone has the presence of mind to go light all the torches at night. It's really kind of them, but who are they? Who is this magical person lighting these torches for us? Alright, that quest is done. Oops, that's my hellhound. I'm gonna shoot him. Wait, what? Did he just transform into something else? I think so. It says the reborn. Kind of seems like maybe he just came right back, which is interesting. Huh. I don't know, man. Hello! Tarnished Shotgun of Insanity. That is a great item name. That is a really good item name. Let's see. Damage to ethereals, to corruptions, casting speed. That's got to be good, right? And an increase in ether damage. Control targets mine for 1.5 seconds. Wait, really? Anyone I shoot? 1.5 seconds? That could be huge. Like those two bosses, if I could just shoot, alternate, and just constantly keep them controlled, that would be something. I don't know. Anyway. Let's see here. There was also an amulet somewhere. Where'd it go? Not that. That's the fabric, that's the gun, which I'm going to definitely equip. But where did that amulet go? I don't know. It was green, wasn't it? I didn't equip it. Did I? No? Oh, this one right there. There it is. Demonic Platinum Amulet. Vitality, Chaos Damage. Offensive ability, some energy regen, and 10% chance of 36 life leech retaliation over 2 seconds. I guess that means life leech. I think retaliation is when they hit you. Like thorns, kind of deal. So that's got physique, cunning, spirit, Health regen. Pierce resistance. I don't actually know if this is better or not. I don't do vitality or chaos damage, I don't think. Or do I? This might actually be chaos damage. Yes, it is. Let me see. Is that the 40? Yeah, that's the 49 that I can do. Oh, so this... I thought this was an aura. But I guess it's not. I guess it attaches to my main hand when it's on? I guess? And I don't do any vitality damage on my main hand, and I don't think I do anywhere else either. The screen still confuses me. The fact that it doesn't... that it only reports your main hand just seems weird, but... did I determine I wasn't going to use these? No, I was looking at this. Oh, right, for the fire damage is what I was looking at. Let me see here. I definitely do lose some of that, but I gain the... it's probably not worth it. I don't do a ton of ether damage, so... yeah, I think I actually was comparing the wrong things here. When I did that before. Man, my brain is fried. Don't play Devil Daggers too much, y'all. Just don't. It's not necessarily in your favor. So I think I'm probably good on this. The physique and cunning are probably better. Since I don't do any vitality damage at all, so we'll just have to sell that. Which is a drag, but it is what it is. Okay. Sorry, forgive the rambling. I'm having to think out loud a lot today. It's amazing how many more health potions I have in this game as opposed to my multiplayer game. Yeah, look at that, dude. That mind control. Something else. On them, it didn't seem to be working. I don't know. It might only be like a chance to actually work. Can't be sure. There's somebody in there. Fighting. Hello, oops. Yeah, I'm not sure what that mind control actually does. Oops, hello, doggy. Oh, it's just... holy smokes. Look at those guys. Can you not do whatever you're doing there? It's like they're just walking toward me when they're mind controlled. I don't know, it's a little weird. Alright, let's check out the Chthonic Heresy. Fear, my brothers, fear ye the Chthonian, for it is the harbinger of our sins. Speak not the name of its master, for it is the manifestation of malevolence and vile intent. Abhor the heretic, for his words are poison to the ears of the faithful. Just as evil must be purged of the soul, so the heretic must be purged of the living. Damn straight. Hi, guys. I want to test what happens when I hit somebody with the mind control, but I kill everyone so fast, it's a little difficult. Hey, more fabric. And the Harbor Master's log for Berwich. Let's check that out. Another boat arrived filled with hooded prisoners, dozens of them. As usual, a wagon was waiting for them, but from what I hear, it doesn't take them far. One of the loading boys came back from Berwich after visiting that their new doctor, and he said the wagon stopped outside the warden's mansion. The lad asked about the prisoners, and one of the handlers said rehabilitation. Not sure what to make of that. There's been over a dozen of these prisoner transports in as many weeks. I just don't see how they can fit them all in that mansion. Don't care how big that place may be, Krieg won't be keeping a prison's worth of no good thieves under his roof. Something peculiar's going on, and it don't settle right in my stomach. Might have to send word up to the lake to Malmuth. Get one of them Inquisitors down here to look into this curiosity. Can't say I want one of them Inquisitors poking around here much either, though. They make a man uneasy. And there was an Inquisitor, wasn't there? I think that was who left the journal in the... the tavern or inn or whatever at the town, the name of which I don't remember. I think they just called it Lower Crossing. Yeah, Lower Crossing. I don't know if that's actually the name of the town. Or if that's even considered a town. I don't know. Okay. Any goodies up here? Apparently. Leather boots of the wolf. Nope. Okay. We're gonna have to go back to town to sell some of this junk at some point soon. Man, what was with that slowdown? Every now and again, this game will just slow down. Not just the hitching, but I've noticed just some, like, the frames just drop. I'm not sure what the deal is with that. I've actually turned the settings down slightly from the maximum. I want to say I dropped, like, particle effects and... What are you doing, dude? I don't know, there may have been something else. Okay, he's mind controlled. Yeah, and he just wandered toward me. Maybe that's not mind control, maybe that's the confusion? Hell if I know. But yeah, this game is... I mean, generally it performs fine, but every now and again... something goes wrong. Yeah, he was mind-controlled. He just runs right up to me. I would assume that would mean they would fight for you. That doesn't appear to be the case. They just run away. Will you die already? Each time I think he died, and he's just backing off a little. Okay, we got, I don't need a revolver. Kind of all about the two-handed stuff in this game, it seems like. So, I've been here? Oh, yeah. Right, these are the estates. I got it. Now let's explore a little more of the surrounding area. I want to see something new here. Trap door that could lead to the warden's cellar. So could all that. There may be multiple points of ingress. right. Plague Bear's Tarnished Great Axe. That actually looks pretty sweet. I'm gonna give that to my other character. That don't seem too bad. Let's see. Let's organize. There we are. That's a little better. I wish it would separate quest items. Aha! Secret passage. They're not super secret because they highlight when you mouse over them. They're honestly pretty hard to miss if you're paying any attention at all.
My inventory is full.
So it is. Alright. Let's head back. Sell this junk. I'm going to be playing a lot of Grim Dawn probably over the next while, to the exclusion of much else. For the simple fact that I'm trying to review this game. Now, that's interesting. Plus 69 energy and plus 31 spirit. I wonder how much energy I would have in, just slightly less with these pants. But I have slightly more armor. No, I don't. Oh, they... Okay. Well, yeah, clearly that's better. Alright, that's fine. Don't need any of this. Yeah. Runebound Archive of Ruin. Magic offhand. Yeah. I guess I'll save the rest of that stuff.
Got something you need stashed?
Yep. Item transfer, buddy. In case I start some more characters. These, I guess I will. I guess I could store these. See if my other guy can use them, maybe. And let's see. Can't complete any more components. I don't know if I should be carrying around all these components. There's so many. So that needs to be sold. So do those. And these. Actually, that. Maybe I'll stick here also. I should really be paying more attention to this stuff. Cold damage, lightning damage? Nah. Oh, yeah. Learned how to craft Glacier, whatever that is. I wish there was a way to, like, auto-transfer these things. Wow. 50 grand. That is a lot of bits. Well. No. Oh, that is such a bummer. You have to actually, like, drag these things over to store them. That's a real bummer. Wish there was some way to just move these things over here very quickly. There really should be. But there doesn't seem to be. That's a shame. Corpse dust? I guess if I'd been doing that all along, then it wouldn't have been so terrible, but And I guess I can just keep the rest of this crap for now, anyway. Oop, seamstress. Let's see what she has to say. Constance. Did you find some fabric? Yes, here it is. Great! There's more than enough to clean the place up a bit. Let's see, we got fortified doublet. That's not bad. Actually looks pretty good. And lots of rep. And some XP. Good stuff. We're very nearly at 20, so that'll be great too. Let's see, should also have some left over to make some new clothes. Many people here are wearing nothing but rags. Please take this jacket. I've been working on these for Briggs and the other guards, but I think you've earned the first one. Thank you. That is very kind of you, Constance. Oh, hey, look at this. This is new, isn't it? I'm quite sure that was... Oh, yeah. Look at that. This dude's got it, too. The cell here. Not there. But yeah, that is new, right? That's not just my imagination. I feel like that happened just after... I'm gonna have to go back and watch the video. Because now I'm just not sure. I'm like, I swear this was all new. This stuff, I would swear to it. It's a little weird that it's in... areas where there's no people. But, whatever. Yeah, like, none of these areas seem to have changed. Yeah, it's like, am I making that up, or did that actually happen? I feel like it did. I feel like it did. Either that, or I'm really...
See anything you like.
Unobservant. Okay. So I can't wear that yet, but that is some way better armor than what I got on. Can I wear it next level? Yeah, I got the physique for it. Health, defense, energy regen, fire, and cold resistance. That's not bad at all. Alright, back we go. And let's level up real quick here for something to shoot. Come on, y'all. Once again, I forgot to summon my dog. We are not leveled quite. I'm still taking damage from poison. Okay. Man, I love those explosions. That was actually kind of what sold me on this game initially. As shallow a thing as it is to say, when they were showing, even early on in the Kickstarter, when they were showing like the work that they'd done and, you know, kind of the overall look of the game. Like, I just loved how everything looked when you were fighting. Just these explosions of color, you know, streaking across everywhere. Like, it just looked cool. And Diablo 3 did a lot of that as well. Some of those effects are really nice, but yet there's something slightly more satisfying about these to me, and I don't know why, because they're less technically impressive on some level, but I don't know. I just kind of like them. I don't know if it's the colors or the fact that there is a little bit less visual fidelity here. I don't know what it is. But whatever the case. Alright, let's see. We can wear this now. Yeah, cool. Good stuff. I don't know why I'm bothering to rearrange that. Alright, well, now we can level up here. Let's see. I will get a little more physique, maybe. Just a little. So what do we get with this guy? Physique, cunning, spirit. Physique, cunning, spirit. Now that's 25, 30, 45. Interesting. Is that because I have more levels than this dude? That must be it. You must get more per level as you go up the chain here. I don't know. Okay, well, let's see. Let's do one more fire strike, I guess. And... what does this do? Destructive power fire strike allows to hit with greater intensity while requiring less energy, but this technique can only be achieved with the proper handling of a melee weapon or two-handed rifle or crossbow. Okay. Huh. Alright. So, plus 25 crit damage. Total damage modified by 15%. And our energy cost goes down. We're never out of energy. I think that's what I determined last time I looked at it. It just doesn't really seem worth it. Intense heat, dangerously sharp shrapnel. Skyfire grenade. Electricity? Man. There is a lot of stuff to consider here. I'm just gonna level this up a bit and at some point take a little more look at this. Imbues the flames with chaotic power that melts enemy flesh and deteriorates armor for our Blackwater cocktails. I think I might just try and like max out those skill trees for the grenade things. I really like the grenades. They're fun. I like throwing grenades and blowing stuff up. And I like firing these big two-handed weapons as well. Oh, oops. Didn't realize this was an exit. Okay, well. We've already been there. Oh wait, is that really it? Wait, for real? I thought there was another passage to explore somewhere. Huh. Okay, I guess this is not the cellar. Not the cellar. So, the warden's house was somewhere else, I guess. Yeah, we already went through all this before. I don't feel the need to duplicate effort. This is new. Get some scrap. I do really like the look of this game. I do. Just the environmental design and such. It's cool. I don't want to say just because it's, you know, Diablo 2-like or anything, but I don't know, it has a thoughtful quality to it. Seems like somebody put in some effort. Everybody explode, please. God, I love those grenades. Warden's house has got to be around here somewhere. Alright. Maybe. Really is a satisfying explosion. I don't actually know how big this area is, so I don't know how much more we'll have to explore before we find what we're looking for. Some slith. These guys are nothing. Wait, who's... Oh, my dog died. Oops. Come on, mosquito. Well, I think the dog's gonna take care of that for us, so we'll let him do that. Some stuff. I guess this just loops around. More games of this type should have guns. I think if I've learned anything from Grim Dawn, it's that. So, wait. I guess I... Did I already explore this at some point? It makes it look like we can go under there, but... We can't. I don't know, man. That's not a shortcut. That's not either. I don't know, I guess. I wish there weren't all these blockages. I don't know if that's something you can blow up. It's got that little, almost looks like a little icon. I don't know if that's actually an icon, or if that's just the map artist saving a little time instead of drawing like a million different little rocks. Well, I guess we gotta trek all the way back up here. Whoa, what was that? That was kind of cool. Somebody just said something. Not a lot of voice work in this game. Which kind of adds to the lonely feel of it, you know? Alright, I think the warden is up here. I think the warden's place is up here. As a matter of fact, does that say Krieg? It does. Residences of Warden Krieg. Cool. Yeah, the atmosphere in this game, like... the opening area is just kind of generic-y. It's like, yeah, hey, it's a... There's a swamp, here's some... Whatever. Like, it's just not very exciting. But the further I go, the more cool stuff I feel like there is. Man, the warden's got, like, a zombie army living in his house. Which, I mean, I guess that was the whole point of all of his experimentation and such. Man, there's a lot of guys in here. I gotta say, this is great fun. It is not challenging because I feel like a badass. I've got some good skills and apparently decent gear. But man, it's fun mowing through these guys and watching them explode. I really like it. It is gleeful in the best possible sense of that word. Where it comes to these kind of games. Alright, let's check out Mr. Krieg's journal. See what he has to say for himself. I have taken possession of my assigned vessel, the local prison warden. Ah, he was possessed. I appeared to him in his bedchamber and proposed the joining. I had anticipated fear and skepticism, but these humans are apparently all too ready to enter into any pact they believe will profit them. Krieg is not a particularly strong-willed human, but he is persistent and constantly scratches at my consciousness. I have him under control, though. Krieg's position as an incarcerator of other humans will greatly facilitate our efforts. His expansive dwelling has a massive cellar I believe we can use to fashion an underground transit to conceal our activities and the transport of bodies. There is much work ahead to prepare for our glorious dawn, but I rather enjoy this physical body. It has many advantages. Alrighty. So, he was possessed by an ethereal, which explains his behavior. Did I miss anything? Guess not. So there's a questy marker over here somewhere. In the cellar, but I don't know where the cellar is. Make sure I didn't miss anything, which looks like... How do we... Oops. Ah, so this was the same Inquisitor. Let's see, I finally arrived in Berwich after passing through the dismal area known as Whitemire. For years, tales of supernatural occurrences have circulated about Whitemire, and indeed the name itself makes one uneasy. I hadn't put much stock in them, but my recent experiences lend some credence to the old tales. Nevertheless, I have reached my destination, and it seems the Warden of Devil's Crossing, who resides in Berwich, somehow anticipated my arrival. A footman greeted me as soon as I entered town and insisted I accept Krieg's invitation to be put up in his manor. I find this very peculiar, but I've accepted the offer as it may be my best chance to investigate the manor itself. I'm going to make this entry short, as I've just been summoned to join Krieg for supper in the dining hall. This should prove illuminating. Boy, I bet it did. I've been a guest to Warden Krieg at his manor for over a week now, and my suspicions that something terrible is going on here grow with each day. Every day I set out to some destination in or around Berwich to investigate yet another unusual crime or ominous rumor. Some are easily dismissed as more mundane human crimes or merely fantastic tales, but many of my investigations have come to darker conclusions. I feel there is a pattern emerging here, but I cannot yet put the pieces together. These are peripheral cases, though, and the main purpose of my involvement in them is to give pretense for my prolonged stay in Berwich. Krieg himself has become the focus of my primary investigation. Despite an overwhelming conviction that Krieg is not what he appears to be, and is almost certainly involved in some sort of unnatural activity, I found no irrefutable evidence of wrongdoing that could be used to open an official inquisition. Well, go to the cellar, dude. Much of the manor itself is closed off to me. There are rooms upstairs which Krieg and other visitors come and go, but I am not permitted to enter. Stranger yet, I've awoken in the night to sounds like the creaking of wagons moving along a road, but then looked out my window down upon the village and seen nothing. Where are these sounds coming from? The game of cat and mouse continues, but as of yet, I'm not certain who is the cat and who is the mouse. The writing's pretty good. I gotta hand it to these guys. The writing is not bad. Like for those little journal entries and stuff, it's pretty decent. Alright, so if we bust out here... This should take us to the cellar. So my guess is Inquisitor Creed met a not entirely pleasant end. Gonna go out on a limb and say that. Ah. And there's a rift. Cool. What's that symbol drawn on all of these? Actually, there's multiple symbols. It's like a sort of evil eye looking thing and a whatever the hell that is. Blockage there. Man, they just decided to throw like every single enemy type in here, I guess. Don't know if I fully explored all this nonsense. Looks like it extends off in a southerly direction. Well, southeastern, I guess? No. That is due north. Yeah, southeastern. Bust open the hidden passage. This is cool. This is cool. They have just areas that are kind of off map like that. I just thought, you know, the secret passages were all kind of going to be limited to, you know, like, oh, here's just a little room. Enjoy. But like, you know, this is the little actual area back here, which isn't on the map, which is kind of cool. Or actually it is on the map. Look at that. That's cool. It's very faint, though. It's not drawn in like the rest of it. It's almost transparent. So it gives you a little something to look at. That's cool. I didn't even notice. That looks like a good helmet. Vitality and chaos damage, spirit, yeah. But the 28 cunning and the cunning increase are going to be better for me. Same as with that other item. Clear's Gold Band of the Wolf. Cunning, physique, health, and health regen. That's not bad. Actually. I think I actually might take that over the Slith ring. Maybe. I don't know if that's a wise move or not. I'll have to stick something else on it. Like a bonus or something at some point, but I feel like, for the time being at least, it is a better item. Okay, we gotta go around. Dead end? No? Yes? Anything good here? No. Some reading material. What's that big ass cellar, man? Warden must have been into some money. How do I get in there? Oh, that's satisfying. So good. Man, this is a long passage. Hello. Hi, guys. What are those things? It's an ether corruption. I don't know what that means, though, you know? Like, what does that really mean? What is an ether corruption? Let's get rid of y'all. Boom! Come on, really? Wand? Alright, let me go check this stuff out here. Emerald is good. I don't care about that. This may be epic amulet. Ooh. Elemental damage. Plus 4% spirit and elemental resistance, and it grants us energy shield, which is a 10% chance when hit, which raises a protective shield that absorbs incoming physical blows. It does quite a lot of damage absorption, but it only protects against physical and piercing attacks. Ah, and it's a set item. Well, I'll probably hold on to it. I don't know that I'm going to actually use it. I think the physique, cunning, health regen, like, that's all kind of more immediately useful to me, because I'm not... Well, yeah, I guess elemental damage would count as all elements, right? Like, or is there some, there is no separate, yeah, so that would be fire damage, right? Fire, lightning, cold? Supposedly I don't do fire damage, but that's only on the main hand. I obviously do when it comes to, not my grenades, but I guess my, these here. So yeah, I don't know. I do fire damage there too. So that's weird. So why is it telling me that I don't do fire damage? Fire damage done per hit with your weapon attacks, including bonuses. Well, dude, right there. It's called Fire Strike. Is that a bug? That's super weird. I definitely do fire damage, right? I mean, right? Why isn't it showing? Plus 36%. It's right there. Main hand damage. And 68 fire damage. I don't know. Well, regardless, I guess maybe we will take this. Maybe. Oh, I can't even wear it yet. Level 25. So, never mind. All that was useless speculation. Oh, look, quest marker. I am guessing. Oh, that's just taking us to the door. Which will be his lab. Let's finish looking at everything else. Wow, this is some. What the F? Dude, what is going on here? That is damaging me. Yes, it is. What is that? Is this the stuff that I'm standing in, or is it this thing? I guess it's just the stuff. Let's just run through here. Huh. Oops. Grab the scrap. Go. Get out. Leave my dog alone. You bastards. Alright. That's a weird effect, man. It's kind of cool. Oh, that's really good stuff. Killing large quantities of zombies with explosives is as satisfying in this setting as it is anywhere. Even though I really don't like zombies anymore. I'm really sick of zombies, but in this context, I can still get behind them. Good Diablo zombies, I always enjoyed. Those were my favorite zombies from the original Diablo. Man, I loved those. They were pretty good in the sequel as well. We're still missing this. Dang it. Well, we gotta go back that way anyway. So, it's okay. Away we go. Let's finish off this floor so we don't lose track of it later. Yeah, here we go. This guy is just a walking firestorm. It's ridiculous. Excuse me. Man, I'm tired. I really am. Those could be good. Alright, let's head back and take a look at these. Spalders, 84 armor, which is substantial. Some health, percentage health increase, and armor. Yeah, but we got a bunch of other stuff on here. Including... yeah, some resistance and... health regen. Okay. Oops. Yeah, that's not something we need. Found any other use for scrap yet. Although, I think that actually was used as a crafting material at the blacksmith, wasn't it? It might have been. Hello! Epic gear! Make them pop. I want to take a look at this. Less armor, but it increases cold damage, massive cunning, attack speed, and plus to knight's chill, which is something we don't have. It probably isn't worth it, since we're not doing cold damage. If we were, it would be. I think. Hello! What do we got here? Rare one-handed cutlass. Yeah. Big two-handed claymore thingy. Alright, whatever. Man. Sorry. Alright, let's just finish off this floor real quick. And then I'll probably take a short break. Ooh, hey, look at that. It's an extra big dude. Rift spawn, whatever you call it. Okay, he's dead. And I got an achievement! Monster Slayer! I have been slaying monsters, in fact. Nah. Okay. Let's just fill in the rest of our map here. Some more gauntlets. Actually, those have a lot of armor. But I don't really need the armor. It's not like I'm in danger on a regular basis. So I'll stick to the damage output. That's always my strategy when it comes to games like this where I feel overpowered. I'm just going to focus on damage, because if I'm already overpowered and nothing's really posing me a threat as far as like risk of death, then I'll just focus on killing everything as fast as possible until I hit a brick wall, you know? My dog. Oh, there's my dog. Or that. I was already in here. How are there so many guys still here? That's kind of crazy. I think I was already here. The map was filled out. Is this not? No, of course not. We got to go around. I wonder if things actually like respawn in here. That would be interesting. Doesn't really look like it, but... Okay. We're going to zip over to the entrance to the lab here. And we're going to stop here for a moment. I'm just going to head back to town, I guess. And, we will leave it there. So with that, I'm going to take a quick break. And, yeah, I'll be back in a few minutes. I just need to, you know, use the restroom, get my water bottle, that kind of stuff. So I will be back in